Welcome back to the Stratus Arena on the campus of Fairleigh Dickinson University, where WCTV, the all-volunteer Axis group, will bring you the 61st Oscar F. Thompson Memorial Bergen County Jamboree, sponsored by the Bergen County Coach Association. Our second game has the 7th seed, Old Japan, versus the 2nd seed, Don Bosco Prep. They're getting ready to announce the team. John, this is a game where you have the size and speed of Don Bosco against the shooting of Old Japan.
Well, Don Bosco isn't going to go inside. They have a 6'9", 6'5", 6'5", guard, but they still can shoot from outside. In the case of Old Japan, who have 4 losses, they have to come out. Minaya's got to have a great game. Plus, the big guy's got to be able to play defense against Lovisolo and Erlington. If they can't play it against those two, it's going to be a long afternoon.
It should be an interesting game. You got Justin Minaya, who's an outstanding basketball player, as a junior, and you got the size and speed of Don Bosco. Now we're going to have the introduction of the both teams by the voice of the Jamboree, Joe Hausman, then the starting lineups, and then we'll have the tip-off of the second of 4 games here at the Stratus Arena, the Rotman Center, on the campus of Fairleigh Dickinson University in Hackensack, New Jersey. Let's go to know the Joe Hausman now.
These are the non-starters.
Number 13, Luke Conway. Number 13. The Nonsco Pep High School. Number 5, Steven Lundus. Number 5. Pro Pep High School. Number 3, George Stamos. Number 3. Number 42, For Navasco Prep High School, number 25, Victor Zanatka, number 25. And for the Ironman of Navasco Prep High School, number 14, Matt Perespe, number 14. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for both teams, beginning with the visitor again, the Golden Knights of Austin Penn High School. Donnie Engard, a 5-foot, 10-inch senior, number one, Brett Franklin, number one. Donnie Engard for the Ironman this afternoon, a 6-foot, 5-inch junior, number 24, Ronald Harper, number 24. And the guard position for the Golden Knights, a 5-foot, 9-inch senior, number 10, Mike Patullo, number 10. And the forward position for the Ironman, Doug Bosco, a 6-foot, 5-inch junior, number 22, Marcellus Burlington, number 22. And the forward position for all the fans, a 6-foot, 2-inch senior, number 4, Gary Slater, number 4. And the forward position for John Musco, a 6-foot, 9-inch senior, number 23, Chris Lovisolo, number 23.
6'9".
And the center position this afternoon for the Golden Knights, a 6-foot, 5-inch senior, number 15, Kevin Iceberg, number 15. And the guard position for the Ironman, a 6-foot senior, number 12, Charlie Bagan, number 12. And starting at forward, this afternoon for the Golden Knights of Old Man, a 6-foot, 6-inch senior, number 11, Justin Manaya, number 11. And for the Ironman, Don Bosco Prep, starting guard, a 6-foot, 5-inch senior, number 1, Chris Paul, number 1. Your starting lineup for the Ironman of Don Bosco Prep High School, Golden Knights of Old Penn High School. The official for this afternoon's second game, Mr. Todd Hoppy, Mr. Ricky Griffin, and Mr. Mike Corcoran.
We're honed in.
Both starting lineups for Don Bosco, Paul, Bagan, Erlington, Lovisolo, and Harper. For Pascal Kills, Franklin, Slater, Patullo, Manaya, and Eifert. We are ready for the second game of four games. After this, John, we have two down, two to go. We got to get this one in the books, though.
Well, this is going to be one of those games. Inside is going to win the game.
Manaya will jump with, I can't see.
Lovisolo.
Lovisolo, yeah. Everybody's in my way.
6'6 against 6'9.
Not bad, huh?
Manaya does everything for this team.
Manaya gets the jump.
Wow. Indirect tip.
Patullo now has hands off to Franklin. Patullo looks back outside. Eifert, he's a big guy. Manaya for the shot, no good. Taken down by Erlington, who is big.
6'5".
And wide.
A great football player, and he's only a junior.
Harper, who didn't play last week, had a bad back, I heard.
And Lovisolo's playing outside, right?
Yep.
6'9".
And that's going to be a backcourt violation. Going to turn over to Otepin. There's Kevin DeVario, the coach of Don Bosco.
Does a great job.
Oh.
Year in and year out.
Gets to the quarters at the Rothman Center, or the Jamboree. A lot of times, Sammy's and has won his share of championships. looking for one this year.
He's 19-1, only one loss at home against Bergen. And you were there.
I was there for that one. What a standing room only crowd that was. Whoa. Hopper. Twists and turns. And they're going to call walk. Now, if you're out to pin, you want to sustain the first 4 or 5 minutes of this game. You don't want it to get out 10-point lead.
Greg Ferraro.
Yeah.
He used to be the coach at Tenafly, I believe, Craig Ferraro.
Okay.
Does a great job. But you're right. That's where, and you got to make those shots.
Manaya makes it.
Should be.
He breaks the seal.
A two.
They gave him 2 points for that. I was waiting.
Yeah, I wasn't sure.
Harper hands to Paul. Bagan, watched by Petullo. No good, put back up by Lovasello.
6 foot 9.
Lovasello gets a rebound. And we're all tied at two.
You know, it was like playing patty cakes. Patty cakes, patty cake. Tip, catch a rebound, make the basket.
Slater. Manaya. Ifrit.
And then you have Erlington on Manaya.
Well, I would. Keep
well,
changing
up. You got the 6'9 in the middle. Lovasola.
Yeah.
Well, they're playing man and man. Now he's going back in.
Franklin takes it back out. Bagan watches him. Franklin puts it up. Rims the basket. Harper with the rebound. Quickly up to Erlington. Erlington drives and there's a collision.
They said walk. Took a little trip to Buffalo.
My son was stuck in Buffalo. Timeout on the court. With 5:11 to go, we're all tied 2-2. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the township of Washington.
That is their first 30-second timeout.
Ifrit goes up and puts it in.
So they work inside, Larry, and get a basket against the taller guys.
Ifrit can work inside with these guys. He's that good. Bagan, who's great from the outside. Don't give him a step. Stolen by Harper. Whoop. Bagan by himself again. No good. Taken down by Erlington. Knocked away. Paul comes up with it.
Was that Manaya on the block?
Looks like it. And it was a walk by Harper and a turnover.
Manaya says, I can stop that. This young man, the junior, All-American football player, he's going to have to choose. I think he'll play football.
Oh, I don't know. Kevin DeVario told me he just loves basketball.
Well,
he's got to make a decision.
Absolutely. A lot of people love him for football.
Backcourt violence. Back. The second one we've seen. In the first 5 minutes
of the
game.
That's very unusual. Yeah. You see that when Teaneck and Highway Hell, you know, as they run, play that defense. So 5-4 with 3:55.
Stolen by Slater as he came around, puts it up and in. 6-5 now. Ulta Pan leads. Lovasello from the outside. That's a three.
You're 6'9". Why not shoot for the outside?
He could hit. Well, they all could shoot. We're going to say this whole game.
Michael Corrin was the one who actually showed the big guys to shoot threes when he played at North Carolina. He lives in Washington Township. He's a buddy of yours.
And we have Manaya working hard. Knocked away by Lovasello, and they're going to say it went off Petullo.
Absolutely.
Number 5, Joseph Leonico.
Joseph DiMicco is in for Pesky. Is in for Ultepin.
Nice move. Nice defense by Minaya. Watch how he steps before the player turns.
Plays the whole game, Minaya does.
Begum with a step. Player. All county, by the way.
And they're going to call jump ball.
He will be all county. His dad is into baseball.
Okay.
You know that, right, Minaya?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You think he has a future on baseball?
No, I think he has a future in basketball.
Basketball.
Lovacello, and the ball comes to Harper, and hits. So it's 10-6. Don Bosco leads. Slater.
So seven turnovers.
Nice feed. He had a nice feed and the foul. Ifrit was fouled.
On 12.
Bagan looks like. Was it Bagan? Yes, Charlie Bagan.
Two shots for Ifrit. And we got what? Six rebounds for Don Bosco. Five rebounds. Oh, no rebounds for Ultepin. Turnover seven for Don Bosco and two for Ultepin. So Ultepin is doing the right thing. No turnovers and staying in the game.
Sal DiBenedetto's in for Ultepin.
He's our favorite.
Well, he has my brother's name, Salvatore. You don't see too many Salvatores. I think they stopped after they made him.
Come on, beautiful Italian name, Salvatore.
Ifrit, Burlington, and the ball knocked away by Ifrit. To Paul, knocked away, taken down by DiBenedetto.
DiAmico was the one who made the great steal. Look at this young man. Count it.
Oh, he put the ball up as he was coming down.
He hung up. Alan Jordan.
I'll tell you what, he is a junior. Minaya is 6 foot six. No, I'm sorry, he's a senior. Take that back.
Senior.
Wow, he's something to watch.
He just glided and stayed up like Jordan used to do.
You're right, a glider, a shooter, and he plays good defense. We've seen him a couple of games now.
He moves and he just hangs out in the air like you and I do.
He's an all-around ball player.
He's the heart and soul of Ultepin. The Golden Knights.
Burlington.
11-10 in favor of Ultepin.
Yep. Jumper. That was Justin Baum, number 14. No good. DiBenedetto brings it up.
122 to go.
Yep. And we have a whistle.
A little push underneath.
Could have been Justin Baum. Yeah, it is. He just checked in, number 14, Justin Baum, for Don Bosco.
That was number 11. Number 12 on a foul. That's Bagan. That's the second foul for Bagan.
Wow, it's quick. Michael Concannon is in for Don Bosco.
And Joe Hausmer agrees with me.
Paul. Ball gets thrown away. I like that. Just dribbles off his hands.
Concannon couldn't get up and get that ball. The ball was about 11 feet high.
DiMicco will throw it in.
Less than a minute.
Yep, under a minute to go. It's one a one-point lead for Ultepin.
Count it. Ooh, I thought it was good.
That was off. That was Minaya's shot was off.
Minaya had a great look at that three-point shot.
Victor Konopka is in for Don Bosco.
He's a sophomore.
Yep, Starting to get some of his sophomores in there. You can see him play more and more. D'Amico throws back out to Efrain.
Konopka's got to be about 6'4", right?
I would say so. Blocked inside.
By him. By 25, Konopka.
No good and a foul. They're going to get, I'm going to get bound. Let's wait. 1-4, bound.
Number 14, Matt Arrasse.
All right. So number 5 makes the first.
So D'Amico gets the second one, and he puts Altepan up by 3.
Excellent first quarter for Altepan.
Concannon. Got that nice red hair, John. Paul. Baum, watch, it's blocked. And no good.
By Minaya.
Oh. So we played one quarter here, 13 to 10. Altepan leads Don Bosco. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the Township of Washington. The Bergen County Coats Association and the Jamboree Committee would like to thank the following corporations for their support in the 61st Oscar M. Thompson Memorial Bergen County Jamboree. TD Bank, The Record, Sports Time, Lifesavers Inc., Gourmet Dining, Washington Community Television. Thank you so very much from the committee for all your support of this year's Jamboree. There's our part of our Jamboree committee. That's Leon Steinberg and Ed Kralmer. Also on the committee you don't see is Paul Puglis, who's the co-chairman with Ed. Leon Steinberg, John Ryan, Ruby Corcoran, Chris Annabelle, and the BCCA liaison is Tom Curry and Chris Gaskin. There we go. We'd like to say that a friend of ours over to our left is covering the game for the Record, Greg Matura. You can read Greg Matura's articles at night before to get up in the morning. He gives you tomorrow's local sports news today at NorthJersey.com. So you go to NorthJersey.com, you look for Greg Matura's article. It'll be there by 8:30, 9 o'clock, and you could beat the rush in the morning. That's NorthJersey.com, Greg Matura.
Well, Larry, it looks like Don Bosco is picking up the defense a little bit, man-to-man.
D'Amico for 3, rims the basket, no good. Konopka with the rebound. Paul drives the lane, whistle, and a foul. Hey, John, how about this gourmet dining bring us the food here with George Kuzma? I didn't get up there yet, but I got great reviews from Bobby Maines.
Unbelievable. That sandwich that you and I had, Italian sandwich, was delicious.
Hey, Slater comes out with the ball. That's Earl of Sandwich. Slater put, I don't know how he got it in. He just got the ball in. The ball was rolling on the ground. He picked it up, threw it in. We have a 5-point lead now.
Against the number one in the county and number two in the tournament.
Stolen. D'Amico on a whistle. They're going to call Paul for a reach-in. Whoa. Now, what's that? Oh, that's the food. That's gourmet dining. That's the gourmet dining that delivered food here.
Boy, that the sauce looks ready to eat.
Don't look too bad, does it?
Looks great. So, with 7:13 to go in the second quarter, 5-point lead for Altepan.
Slater hands to Minaya. Minaya stops with a runner. No good. Taken down by Erlington. Erlington has it. Over to Harper. Harper drives in, underhand, and lays it in. Very slick ball player. Harper. D'Amico. Oh, he had a look. No good. That was DiBenedetto with the look. Had a good look at the basket. Harper has a good look. No good.
Over the back, number four.
Yep. We're going to call
Dorme.
Dorme went over.
Dorme, Dorme. 6 foot seven.
That's Dorme. Manly Dorme, number four, who checked in, picked up his foul.
So it's 6-1 in fouls, by the way.
Slater, good move. Ball was put back up and a foul.
Looks like they got Arlington.
Yeah, you know what? They got it on Arlington, it looks like.
Nope. On Baker. The candle maker.
Baker, yep.
The candle maker. That's the second foul for
Baker
Pan.
Okay. John Cannon. Watched by DiBenedetto. Baum inside to Arlington. Loses the ball, taken by Minaya. Up quickly. Benedetto lays it up and in. Sal DiBenedetto. And it's a 5-point Old Japan lead.
Oh, Salvatore DiBenedetto. Part of the Italian connection at Old Japan.
Harper from the outside, he gets it.
3 points for Harper.
So it's a 2-point game, 17 to 15. Minaya, still working, puts it up, no good, taken down by Baum. Over to Concannon, quickly over to Dorme. And he rolls the ball out of bounds, goes back over to Otapin as Bacon will come in, and I think Concannon will sit down. Yes.
5:01 to go in the second quarter.
Slater will bring it up and hands to Minaya.
Does everything, Mr. Minaya. He'd be a great high jumper. He's lanky.
I think he could do anything. He's just an athlete.
Oh, outstanding athlete. Must have taken everything from his dad.
Who knows? what a nice play. That was a give and go and a foul.
Salvatore DiBenedetto.
And D'Amico goes to the line. So D'Amico continues the 5-point, a 3-point play. Petullo is in. And D'Amico will sit, and it's a 5-point lead for Old Japan.
Old Japan has 13 turnovers at this point. And two block shot. Oh, for Don Bosco, I'm sorry.
Arlington. Slater tried to come around and steal the ball. These are the Dwight Englewood team.
Bulldogs. The young Bulldogs.
They're young puppy dogs. Puppy Bulldogs.
They have three sophomores that start.
They're eating and drinking.
Wow. And watching Don Bosco. And Old Japan, as Old Japan has a 5-point lead.
They will play T-Neck in the third game.
That will be a track meet.
Bagley wanted, stops, puts a runner up, gets the rim.
Shooter's roll.
Franklin brings it up over to Slater. Knocked away by Dorme, ahead to Arlington.
Oh,
puts it up.
He passed himself on the basket.
So one first game
point.
Now, John.
That's the first point for Arlington.
20-19, Old Japan leads. Slater.
It's been all Old Japan this first half. The undersized Golden Knights Have a one-point lead.
Petullo brings it back out.
Sitting in a zone. Matchup zone.
Yep.
A la Syracuse.
Petullo wants a three-pointer. No good. Harper has it. Over the bum. Cross court. Bacon. Burlington. Bacon was way outside. He thought of it. Harper.
He's a shooter.
Baum rolls it into Dorme. Dorme. Back out to Bacon. Bacon. They're going to call a push on Petullo. This is the Bulldog coaching staff.
That's Bob Rudolph on the left, all the way on the left, with the DE for Dwight Englewood.
Yeah, he just took over this year. Longtime coach in the Bergen County.
And in doing so, I missed the foul, but that's all right. We'll pick it up at halftime. A little weave on a part of the Ironman.
Yep. Rebound, no good. Eifert. D'Amico.
Oh, nice
D'Amico,
move.
Not yet. Knocked away by Harper. Taken down by Bagwell. Cross court. To the basket, no good. And a foul.
Jump off.
Horatsme went all the way down.
It's going to be, looks like this, to Don Bosco on the jump ball.
Jumper is good.
Burlington. 2-point goal, close to a three.
Close. Well, Don Bosco takes a 2-point lead.
Or was it? It must have been a three. Well, it was a three, Larry.
I had my head down 20. With a, putting some notes down.
Yeah, 20, yep.
22-20.
Good thing I keep score. So Arlington's got 5 points.
Manaya.
Oh, that was beautiful.
Now, no doubt about that, right?
Nah. Young men, if you want to shoot a 3-point, elevate at the height and then shoot the three. But you got to be 6'7 or 6'5 as Manaya.
Bacon, over to Harper, Horazme. He hits. Matt Horazme, a junior, just hit for three. And we have a timeout on the court with 1:12 to go. It's a 25-23 point lead for Don Bosco over Old Japan. The Bergen County Coach Association and Jamboree Committee would like to thank the staff and the Electric Department of Fairleigh Dickinson University for hosting the quarterfinals, which are today. Semifinals will be next Sunday here at the Stratus Center, Stratus Arena, and the finals will be on Friday, February the 25th at 7 p.m. John Frick, go to get some more stats. This is the gourmet dining. That looks like a nice salad. I'm going to try to get up there.
Yeah, it looks great. Manaya has 2 blocks. Manaya also has 10 points. He's a heck of a ball player, and I'm going to include that Manaya should be all-county.
Oh.
We haven't seen too much of Northern Valley or Tapan, but he is a player. And Chris and Craig Ferraro does a great job.
Tomiko looking.
Under a minute.
There we go.
Manaya. You have your clock on the screen.
Slater backs it up. They're far away from the basket now.
Looking for a last shot. Ooh.
And they're going to call a walk.
A little.
They said Franklin walked.
And a couple of baby steps. 5 turnovers for Old Japan. 13 turnovers for Don Bosco. And wow. That's the difference in this game, ladies and gentlemen.
Even though it's a 2-point lead for Bosco, all those turnovers. Unbecoming for a Bosco team.
For the 1 and 2.
Here's your time on the right-hand corner. Horatsme. Concannon holding it out. 20 seconds. This will be for the last shot. Unless they get a good one. Harper will pull it out with 10 seconds to go. Harass me. Hands to Concannon. 5 seconds. Oh, Slater tried to. What Slater did, he tried to time the move so he could steal the ball, but Graham Wright didn't.
It's their fifth foul, so no shooting foul.
They could give a foul, so that was a good play.
It was a good play, very good play. Probably called by Craig Ferraro. Foul him. Prevent the basket.
Goes up, puts it up. No good. Wait, they're waving it off. They're waving the shot off. So we played the first half here at the Stratus Arena. It's 25-23. Don Bosco Prep leads Old Dominion. You are watching WCTV, the Old Volunteer Group, Township of Washington. We're here at halftime, 25-23. Don Bosco leads Old Dominion. This is the second of four games here at the quarterfinal. John Francolo has the statistics from our statistical department at WCTV.
Just quickly, for Old Dominion, 23 points. Slater had 4. D'Amico had 5. Minaya had 8. Sal DiBenedetto, 2. 4 for Eifert. Total of 23. 4 Don Bosco. Bagan had 5. Harasmi had 3. Erlington had 5. Mobisolo, 5. Harper, 7. The big reason why the score is 2 points. Turnovers for Don Bosco, 13. 5 for Old Dominion. 8 differential, which kept Old Dominion in the game. Also rebound, Don Bosco 15-3 for Old Dominion. So that offset some of the turnovers.
There you have it. You have turnovers and you're beating a team 15-3. You see how the score, when you put everything together, those statistics will show a close even game. And that's what we have here, 25-23. Old Dominion is playing very, very well. They're playing a consistent game. We're ready. So Effort puts it up, no good, banging around, and out of bounds. So the ball goes over to Don Bosco. Bacon will bring it up. Bacon will bring it up. Ball. Lovacello inside to Erlington, puts it up, and gets it in.
So Erlington goes to 7 points. And I believe that Erlington had, what, 5 turnovers in the game in the first half. So that's been a problem today.
Oh. They are going to call a walk on D'Amico.
He was on his way to Buffalo.
Bacon will bring it up slowly.
That's Lake Ontario, I believe. Also, Lake Erie's in the area. A lot of snow up there.
Lovacello rims the basket, taken down by Minaya. Oh. Behind his back. And he tries to cut between two players, and they're going to call
on 22.
I think 22, yeah. On Erlington. Minaya tried to slip through two players. D'Amico will throw it in. Stolen by Erlington. Foul and the basket, no good.
He'll get two.
Erlington will go to the line for 1. And now another one. Fouled in the
act of shooting.
Petullo will come in, number 10. And Arlington hits two.
So he's up to nine. Just the start of the third quarter.
Petullo from the outside.
Gotta get the ball to Minaya.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
And they have Paul watching.
The ball gets knocked away.
Double team.
Arlington is ahead.
Oh!
Oh, Minaya with a big block. Whoa!
It was about 12 feet in the air.
If it puts it up and in. What a play. We haven't got a chance to say how great that play was by Minaya on Arlington.
Oh, my goodness.
A triple A play.
He was up around 12 feet. He could put a quarter on top of the backboard.
29-25, Don Bosco leads. And Franklin.
That's the third block by Minaya in this game.
Like I said, John, he's an all-around ball player. Absolutely fantastic.
Unofficially all-county.
Oh, you would think so. That's Coach Ferraro.
Craig Ferraro.
Begging.
What an outstanding game.
Burlington from outside, no good. Taken down by the rebound again. Another rebound. Minaya. Back out to Slater, over to Franklin.
Now you want to work a good shot here.
Outside, no good, comes to Harper. Harper throws it down court, the ball.
That would have been, there was a foul. Whistle. There was a foul at the start. What an athletic
Slater
move.
For Holt.
What an athletic move by Harper as he spinned around in the air and threw a perfect pass.
Well, Slater picked up the foul. Here he is.
He's got number three.
And we have a timeout on the court with 5:30 to go. 29-25. Don Bosco leads Alta Penn. All right. Go ahead, John.
Well, just talking about 16 rebounds for Don Bosco, 5 to Alta Penn. Turnovers 13 for Don Bosco, 8. So the differential. You have a result of a four-point game in favor of Don Bosco.
All right, very good. Harper now back out to Paul, and it got tipped away again by Franklin.
You know, this zone, matchup zone, is doing a great job for Alta Penn.
They're not making the passes. They're taking
the lanes away.
The passing lanes away, and they're knocking the ball, stealing it, or knocking the ball
now,
away.
Now, Bagan, number 12, guess what he got on the SAT?
What?
2,500, a perfect score.
Wow.
He's got a choice of school to go to in the country. He may go to Europe.
No.
Rhodes Scholar. No.
Rhodes Scholar.
Kidding. I'm kidding. 2,500 big ones. That's a perfect score.
Harper for three, bounds around. Paul comes up with it. Burlington and Harper play catch. Now Paul and Harper play catch. Paul and Bagan play catch.
Hey, they're just going to sit and relax. Ooh.
And they're going to call a foul, I think, maybe on Minaya.
Let's wait.
I think they called it on number one, Franklin.
All right, I'll give one to Franklin.
Jumper, no good by Bagan.
Oh.
Taken down by Arlington.
Well, they're just going to sit out here.
Back out here to Harper. Paul brings it out.
What a great job Alta Penn is doing on defense, ladies and
gentlemen.
There's Bagan.
Your 2,500 just whacked one in from the out from the corner.
Can you believe that?
32-25.
You go into school and you say, oh, so how did you do on the SAT? Oh, I got a 2,500. Get out of here.
Paul with the rebound or the Evan Pants. Back out to Bagan. You know, he shoots the ball and scores his points in the game. Like he's not forcing anything.
Right.
and the ball gets knocked out of bounds.
Been 7-2 in this quarter.
Man, look at the young men eating.
You know that? Oh my goodness, look, they're all eating.
Ooh, eat all that stuff. You have some stomachache. At least I would.
Oh, we'd be bouncing off the wall with the sugar intake.
No, we'd be at our doctor's office with A1C. They call it, Bobby. A1C. You got it right?
A1C.
Yeah, I don't know what it is, but it sounds good.
Sound good. You could have said 2CB.
Well, no, I know it's A1C and it's sugar, but I don't know what it does.
I'm not into sugar.
If it was blocked by Lovacello,
I'm
the bacon.
Close it to salt.
Quickly to Paul. Chris puts it up.
Count
and
it.
And he gets the foul. Count it. John, I know an A1C measures the amount of sugar in the for 3 months. Bobby knows. And if you, God forbid, you're a diabetic, you're all too well know what an A1C is.
So,
Di Benedetto's checking in.
Get it.
For Old Japan. And Petullo will sit down as Paul goes to the line to complete the 3-point play and maybe give Vasco a 10-point lead. He hits it.
So it's 10-point lead all of a sudden.
Just like that.
Only 2 points have scored by Old Japan in the third quarter. Has to be the defense.
Oh, yeah.
12-2 run.
Dorme Manley's back in for
12-2 Bosco. Run, Larry.
Stolen by Bagley, right in front of us.
Oh!
Gets it up front. Taken back by Barker. And a whistle on the play. They're going to say a walk.
I guess, really what I'm doing, I'm trying to build up my Fitbit to get a couple of steps. I need 10,000.
John be running around this track pretty soon.
They're not giving me a chance.
Here's Harper now. He had the ball with 2:26 to go and a 10-point lead for Don Bosco.
That was a very demonstrative exhibition of a walk.
Harper
by me.
For three. Rims the basket. No good. How you like that bacon coming in? No one blocked him out.
Timeout.
And a whistle on the play. They're going to call a foul on Franklin of Old Japan as Don Bosco pulls now to a 12-point lead. It was 2.5.
Rebound differential, 21-5. This is Kevin DeVario calling a play, the head coach. How about Bagan?
Oh, blocked inside by Minaya again. But
how about Minaya? Fourth block for Minaya. Mark that to our statistician. We're in this game.
Harper from the corner. Give him the three.
3 points.
A 15-point lead for Don Bosco. 40-25.
A little double team on Minaya.
Yep, every time he touches the ball.
Oh, he's instant offense and defense.
Knocked down by Harper.
That was Dina Bedard.
Dorme.
Oh!
Dorme dunks. Manly Dorme, what a dunk.
My goodness, they got to give him one more point up there, though. They only gave 42. That was a three-pointer, two-pointer?
Two-pointer.
That's the reason why they...
And a whistle on the play as Minaya drove the basket. Wow, they're calling on Earlington. Horesmi's coming in, number 14, along with Lovacello for Don Bosco.
Yeah, I decided to give on that dunk an extra point.
Oh, it's okay.
And I got to take it back.
For
though.
You, though. Minaya from the outside.
Step
wants
back.
Three, and he gets it. And that breaks a long, long streak of not scoring.
11 points for Minaya.
Congrats, mate. Over to Paul. And a whistle.
Looks like a reach-in foul.
Looks like effort. 1-5.
You're right.
Eifert with the foul. 40 seconds to go in the third. 42-28. Don Bosco leads. They've opened it up here. Lovasello. No good. D'Amico with the rebound to Minaya. We have 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Minaya brings it up, wants it from way downfield. Bouncing around, no good. Taken down by Megan. Comes up. Bigham. Watched by Di Benedetto. Gonna go for last shot. 10 seconds. 8 seconds. 6 seconds. Charlie puts it up and he's fouled.
He'll get two.
That was a reverse. Tried to scoop it up there and he'll go to the line for 2 points with 4.2 seconds to go in the third quarter. Here's the first shot. And no good. Minaya has it. There's 3 seconds. He's going to have to put it up. He puts it up. Good if it goes. No good. So he played three quarters here at the Stratus Arena on the campus of Philly Dickens University. Don Bosco leads Holt Japan 43-28. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer cable access group from the township of Washington. The Bergen County Jamboree 2017 high school basketball games will air throughout February and March on the channel you are watching. Please check our website for a schedule. All games eventually will be seen on www.wctv.us. Go down to the YouTube link, hit it, and the games will be there. And we hope you enjoy it. Hey, there's Gourmet. I have to go up and take a look at this. We got to send some people up there to eat. I can't believe there's still more food up there. Well, we're getting ready for the fourth quarter, 43-28. Just to give you a note, Don Bosco has just committed 2 fouls, and Old Japan has 7. So they are in the penalty on the next foul. They are 1-1.
Turnovers 15-9. And the big difference is 22-6 on rebounds.
Who's that, Bergen 22?
Don Bosco 22-6.
Don Bosco?
To Old Japan.
Erasme in, Harper. Stolen by DiBedeno. Concannon tried to cut him off, couldn't do it. Here comes Concannon. Lovasello, no good, comes down. Quickly,
oh,
up to Minaya. Minaya is fouled.
He'll shoot two.
Harper wasn't going to let him score. Minaya missed the first one. Minaya hits one out of two. Makes it a 43-31 game. There goes Garrett.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Outstanding camera person.
Working now as a he's in college. He's
doing
an internship.
Back.
He's interning for Fox News. He told me he's going to be working on the Hannity show at night.
Not bad.
Not bad. Begin holds. Watched by Di Benedetto. Whoop. Harper. Has
oh.
It. Somehow he got the ball around his legs. He picked the the ball off the floor, around his back, and laid it in. Made it look easy. Slater bounces around. Benaya gets in there. Bagan has a harassment, saved the ball from going out of bounds. Bagan brings it up. Looking for a screen. Novacello. And we have a whistle.
Still not in doubt, you know, only 14 points in the fourth quarter.
We have a timeout on the court. And there's Nick. Looks like he's sleeping over there. There we go. Woke him up. Right in front of him is rookie Corcoran.
Well, I think rookie was hiding him.
Yeah.
He was taking a little snooze, so.
All right, there's the way we did this last game. Here's how we got to this point. Don Bosco knocked off Tenafly last Sunday. And that's last Sunday. Altapan knocked off Riverdale. Here we go, Bosco versus Altapan. And here's Emily. There's Emily. Emily just got here. How was the weather? Pretty good? Well,
Well, that's good.
Are we going to make it home or we have to sleep here tonight? Oh, we're going to be sliding home. Okay. Here's Ida.
She's doing, she must have a fifth bit in the hand. She's jumping, trying to get more steps. Right now, turnovers 16 to 10 in favor of Don Bosco. But that's a dubious record.
Yeah, yeah.
As they say. And Don Bosco had 22 rebounds to 8. That's a positive difference.
Well, that's a 14-point lead now. Bagan. Altapan, looks like they're stepping up the defense.
Well, you know, you're down 14. You got a shot, 6-17. You can't let Bagan shoot. But he's got a slide ruler. He's figuring out how he's going to go to the hoop with the 2,500 SAT.
Di Benedetto watching him. Arlington. I mean, Bosco was in no rush to shoot the ball. See a lot of weaving here, looking for something. Well, Bagan shoots and the ball will roll out of bounds. This is Greg Matsura, who was covering this game for the record.
He's and starting to put together.
You see the two articles.
What he's going to write.
You know, you go
he
at night.
He does a great job.
This, you know, tonight I can watch it. I can read it tonight. I can read what I reported on tonight. This is what I really saw. Slater will go to the line. Basket is good.
All these foul shots are important.
And Slater knocks in two.
So we're looking at 12-point differential.
5 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the game. The winner moves on to the Final Four and will meet St. Joe's. Stolen by Di Benedetto.
Whoop!
Into Minaya. Minaya's deep. D'Amico will be short. Harper will have. Stolen by D'Amico. By Harper. And we have a foul. Going the other way, over
11,
the top.
Number 11, Minaya.
There were a lot of steals there.
They had a couple of capabilities. They had to make those shots. As the coach says, keep it up, keep it up. You're only down 12.
Those points, that could disappear.
Well,
quickly.
You had two layups there.
Like it's I said,
a turnover.
It can, a couple of turnovers here and there. 5 minutes flat to go in the game.
They're checking the clock. Oh, they have it.
I think they're gonna put Bosco on the line because they're gonna, let's see what, I don't know what they're discussing. I saw Jim Conville put up 1-1 now.
Oh, okay, so it could be they didn't get the second shot. Oh wait, no. Well, this is good. You know, you discuss it, and then you're gonna come out, you'll tell the coach nicely, You're right or you're wrong. Here it is. They're talking.
Let's see now. Now they're going to explain to Coach Ferraro what the deal is.
You know why they did this, Larry? To give us a little bit of time to relax.
Looks like we're going to have a one-on-one over here.
One-on-one.
So Paul will go to the line for one-and-one.
So 24 is on the line.
Now they're over discussing everything with Pete DeFranco. And the refs there on the side. There it is. There's Pete DeFranco.
Well, he's in charge of the signing, so they put heads together. They're going to talk about it. And both coaches are watching.
You notice both coaches are incredulous? They're just looking like, what?
You know, they're tired. You know, they're watching these kids running up and down. Craig Ferraro is trying to explain his cause. And Kevin DeVario sitting back saying, no,
he's trying
to
explain his side. And we got two arguments.
And at this point, they got to make a decision.
Maybe the two coaches are going to decide to discuss it.
Well, if we could put Tiddlywinks, flip the coin, or maybe, what else could they do?
Let's hear what Joe has to say.
So Ronald Harper is getting a bonus shot.
It's 1-1 for Harper, but I didn't hear who that foul was on. We're too far away to ask.
Yeah, I've lost it.
Harper makes it.
Hey, Greg, who's the foul on?
He doesn't know, right? Was on Minaya?
We got the word from Greg Matura. It's on the foul was on Minaya, 1-1, and Harper made it. So it's 47-33.
And Minaya's third foul.
Minaya shoots, no good. Comes out. Erlington has down the court. And he is held up and fouled by Baker.
Now, would you get in front of number 22 on a full count?
Only if I had you in front of me.
In other words, your answer is no.
The answer is a resounding no.
Could you imagine if I had to get in front of him? He hit me, he knocked me all the way to Washington Township. See that?
Off.
Not even thinking of hitting me.
he makes one. So it's 48-33, 15 points with 4:44 to go. Di Benedetto, watched by Bagley. Knocked away by Erlington.
We could say, Larry, that the winner of this game will be playing St. Joe's in the semifinals.
Absolutely, next week.
So there you have it. One of these two.
5-7. Get here early. We should break. Final four should be pretty good. Foul.
Yeah, on the floor, as they say. Number 12.
Charlie Bagley with a foul. So Begum with the foul. Oh. So his basket was good, 48-35.
So Slater made two,
ball
I guess.
Almost lost, and it went to Dorme's legs, up the court to D'Amico. Erlington knocks it out of bounds.
As he says, this is my territory, young man.
This is my house.
20 rebounds to turnovers, to 11 turnovers, a 9 and you have 13 points, and you take the rebound situation, and you got a few mistakes, but that's the reason
for 13
points.
What are the turnovers, John? I didn't hear it. I was...
Turnovers, 20 to 11.
Who's leading?
Don Bosco's got 20 to 11. Right?
That's a lot of turnovers.
That is a lot of turnovers. Usually when you have 20 turnovers, you don't win.
No. Another turnover.
Yep.
And another foul by Harper.
So. Not only four fouls this half against Don Bosco.
Petullo brings it up.
And 10 for Otapan.
Minaya goes to the basket. No good, banging around. Harper with a big rebound. We're gonna have a timeout.
A coach is
Bosco
allowed.
Had the ball and DeVario called timeout with 3:16 to go.
Excellent.
The Bergen County Coach Association, the Jamboree Committee, would like to thank the following organizations for sponsoring this year's Jamboree. TD Bank, The Record, Sports Time, Lifesavers, Inc. Gourmet Dining provided the food here today up at the Stratus. George Kuzma, want to thank him so very much. And of course, Washington Township Community Television. Here's the Gourmet Dining. This is before Pete got to it. There's a picture of it after Pete got to it, where you don't even see the molecule.
So this quarter has been 7-5.
Bobby, wave your hand, Bobby Mays.
Now, he does not look like John Francola.
That's Pete from Bergen Catholic. He is the announcer at the Bergen Catholic press box. Wait, Pete. There he is.
Look at it. Look at Bobby. Bobby's trying to imitate me. What? Can you do this, Bobby? Look, there's nothing there. Look, it's open. There's nothing. You got to grow hair, my man.
He wants a shirt.
He wants my shirt.
Bobby wants a shirt.
Yeah. He's trying to rip it off, guys. Hey.
Better be careful. Don't put that shirt down anywhere.
3:14. I put it in the locker when I get home.
You better.
My wife can't touch it.
Megan, they're going to double team him. Burlington. And the ball is knocked out of bounds by Slater.
Tell you, Otapan is doing a great job in this game. And no matter what happens in this game, Otapan will be a team that will be reckoned with in their state tournament.
Oh, absolutely.
And Craig Ferrara is doing a great job.
We didn't get a chance to say the same thing about Pascal Kilns.
Absolutely.
And D'Amico files Arlington.
Two shots.
So Arlington will go to the line for two. Misses the first one.
He has 10 points below his season average.
Yep.
He's around 16 to 17 points, I believe. One out of two.
Not bad.
Eyes are blue.
49-35.
14-point lead, 244.
Yeah, 244 to go. This game is just about salted away. This basket here, we'll see where we are. Slater.
Look good.
No good. Harper with the rebound. Stole. Oh, I thought D'Amico was able to knock the ball away. They're going to call a foul. And Don Bosco will go to the line for two shots, not one and one.
Third foul on Joseph D'Amico. Two shots for number 24, Ronald Harper.
So Harper's going to line for two. Misses the first one. And he will try to get Don Bosco to the 50-point mark. He misses both of them, very rare. Petullo brings it up. There's a heartbeat for Ultepin. Slater feeds back outside of Barker. Shoots, no good. Put it, no good. Taken down by Paul. Yeah. Over to Arlington.
Oh, nice assist. No.
No good.
Got to take the assist back.
This is D'Amico in front court. Petullo by himself. Rims the basket, no good. And Bacon has. Puts it into Arlington. Arlington skips around one. To Harper, blocked by Minaya.
Minaya
back up by
block.
Paul. We're at 140 mark, 51-35. No good, Bacon with the lead. Inside to Slater, out to Minaya. The ball jibs off his hands, goes out of bounds. With 1:28 to go, Ultepin calls a timeout. Don Bosco will move on to the semifinals. And they will play St. Joe's.
So St. Joe's, the once the two seed will play the three seed.
So the two will play the three. Will the one play the four? Or the two play the, we don't know. The semifinal game will be next Sunday, 1 week from today, almost to the minute, with 2 hours to spare. February 19th, that'll be the final four. Games will be at 5 and 7. I'm gonna double check that, but I'm almost sure.
I believe that's
and then
correct.
The championship game will be Friday night, February 24th. We're gonna have a surprise guest analysis taking up John Faircola's place. We're not gonna tell you who it is until you tune in and see. Someone many, many, many of you already know. And here just, we are.
Just a couple of stats.
Go ahead, John, do the stats real quick.
Seven rebound. Arlington, 6 rebound. Turnovers, 21 to 13.
Don Bosco has 21 turnovers?
Don Bosco got 27 rebounds and 21 turnovers.
Wow.
And that's really the gist of the score. Those differentials.
Want to thank Bobby Maines and Pete for all their work here with the statistics. They're going to be tired when they get home. Bobby Hand's going to have hand problems. Carpal tunnel syndrome. Arlington to Paul. Back to Arlington. Who jams it in? 53-35. Minaya.
He was using the glass that
time. Hey, that was nice by Petullo.
And a timeout.
And a timeout by Ultepin.
That could
with
be
1 minute and 2 seconds to go. 53-37. All right, we're back with 102 to go.
16-point difference.
And Bosco will put it in. Harper, we're under a minute to go. Next game will be Teaneck and Dwight Englewood. Arlington will go to the line.
48.5 seconds ago.
It's the first one. John, look at the crowd trying to come in over our left shoulder. Did you see that?
Oh, yeah.
They barely will fit. Arlington with two.
to 37. They're all saying Ultepin has done a great job against the number one or number two seed. Number one in county, number two in the Jamboree.
Manaya from way downtown. Corcoran with the rebound. And Bosco just hold it up.
Yeah.
Knocked away by D'Amico. D'Amico will shoot. No good. Come back out. Petullo, he'll try for three. No good. Come out to Baker, turn around. He'll shoot for three. No good. And Kopechne finally has it. Hands to Harper. We have 18 seconds to go.
They bring it back out, which is what you should have. No foul. No foul.
12 seconds to go. And
my coaching came out of me, and I apologize. You know, with 12 seconds to go, come on. You don't foul. These fans are waiting to get in. They're going to yell at us. We're making this game too long.
Corcoran hits the first. Corcoran hits the first one. John's going to give you the stats real quick because we got to get ready for a third game.
Absolutely.
Which is Chinek and Dwight Englewood. You're going to be interested in that one. That's going to be run, 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 and then run some more. Manaya with 10 seconds to go. Petullo, Slater. And that'll do it. 57-37. And you know, John, it's the same score, 57, that St. Joe's had.
You're right.
So Don Bosco will move on to play St. Joe's Regional next Sunday in the Final Four. Two teams have been picked. We got two more teams to be picked to make it. And then we'll have the semifinals next week here. Great game. Ultra Pin put up a great game. Manaya had a wonderful game. He just was up against a team that had size and agility. The coaches shake hands with each other. Kevin DeVario will come back next Sunday. So John will give you the statistics, and then we'll get ready for the next game. Go ahead, John.
What was the final score?
Final score was 57-37. Don
Bosco.
All right,
for Otapan. Slater had 8. D'Amico had 5. Petullo had 2. 12 for Manaya. Great job. Di Benedetto, 4. And Eifert, 6. For the winning Don Bosco, now 20-1. Paul with 5. Dorme, 3. 2 for Corcoran. 11 for Bagan. 3 for Asme. Erlington at 15. Lovasola, 5. I'm Horse, 14. Final score, 57-37.
Well, that's it for the second game. We get ready for the third game. We hope you enjoyed this. Stay tuned for our third game, Dwight Englewood versus Chinek.